Hey guys, today we are at a unique place called the Jantar Mantar in India. But what is this? This is a giant wall and it has two curves intersecting in the middle. You can compare my size with the size of the wall. If you take a closer look, you will notice that the wall has markings all over it. Believe it or not, this is an astronomical instrument built about 300 years ago, and even today, it works accurately. How does it work? If you look carefully on top of this curve, you see that? What is that? That is a small rod plugged into the wall. Is this a coincidence? Maybe to hang a photo? No, if you look on the other side again, you will see a small rod. These rods must have been installed for a specific reason, right? You can see the stairs to climb up, but I'm not allowed to climb on it and use it. So we have recreated this in our lab here. It is a simple instrument made at a smaller scale. At the top, we have put two nails, and from the nails, there are threads hanging. Now, we need the sun to test this, so we need a small-scale sun. So, we built a small electric device that mimics the sun and how it travels. As you can see, there is a light source on this arm, and this is the sun, and these arms can make it move very much like the sun. My team has given it a fancy name for this. They're calling it the solar pathway replicator, but it is a simple device operated by a motor which can move in different axes and in different speeds. Now imagine this is the sun and this is the wall at Jantar Mantar. Look carefully. Without the sun, there is no shadow cast from the needle at all. But watch what happens when the sun rises in the east in the morning. As the sun moves up, you can see the shadow being cast at an angle. Now, I'm holding the thread in the same line as the shadow, and I will extend it all the way to here. And here, the thread touches a certain reading. This measures the angle. We have to make a note of this reading, and it's called the altitude of the sun. Now, what is the altitude? Normally, it refers to height. We say the altitude of Mount Everest is 29,000 feet. But in astronomy, altitude refers to the angle. It has the units of degrees. And you can also calculate the zenith distance, which is 90 degrees minus the altitude. So if the sun's altitude is 30 degrees, the zenith distance will be 60 degrees. Why do we need this? Let's say I take another measurement an hour later, the altitude will change, and at midday, the altitude will be highest. And then again, as the sun proceeds to set in the west, the altitude will start reducing. Now, this works during daytime, but what about the nighttime, right? You can also use it during nighttime. You can see any other celestial object, the moon, for example. There is no need for the shadow. Hold the thread from the moon pointing at it, and then measure the altitude. You can also measure the altitude of any star or planet using the same technique. But there is a surprise waiting for you on the other side of the wall. Here, on the opposite side, you can see a large semicircle. If you look up, there are no metal rods on this side or on the other side. What happened to the metal rods? The metal rod has moved to the middle. Actually, this is the same instrument as the other side of the wall. And you can say, Praveen, they look completely different. This is a semicircle And this looks like two quadrants intersecting. Exactly. If you take these two curves and put them together, they become this semicircle. Now, this helps us understand something important. We all know that the sun rises from the east and sets in the west every day. But do you know that the sun also moves from north to south and back gradually? This is what causes the seasons and also how we calculate the year and annual events like solstices and equinoxes. So during the month of March, the sun will rise due east, meaning the sun will be on top. And if you see the shadow from the needle and extend the thread following it, the thread will mark 90 degrees. This reading is called the declination of the sun. Now, every day the sun will slowly move towards north, and in June, it will reach its northernmost point, and the shadow will be cast at 23.5 degrees, although the markings might show 90 minus the angle. Again, the sun will start going back south, and it will reach the midpoint here, and then it will reach the southernmost point at 23.5 degrees here, completing a full year. If you use this device and start measuring the sun at any particular day, and if the sun traces an entire path and comes back to its starting point, 365 days would have passed. So using this device, you can calculate the year, the seasons, and solar events like equinox and solstice. It's quite crazy to think that just by building a simple wall and drawing four quadrants, ancient builders were able to calculate not only the daily motion of celestial objects, but also how they move around through the year. But even this simple wall cannot be built without the Polaris telescope. Today, you cannot just randomly build a wall and make this work. Let me demonstrate something. If I put my phone here, see, it's not randomly built. It's built exactly aligned to the north-south axis. Remember, in the previous video, I told you that the Polaris telescope, or the Dhruva Darshak Yantra, was the first device ancient builders would have needed. And after building it and determining the north-south axis, this was the second device they built. This is why it's called the Dakshinottara Bhitti Yantra. What a complex name, right? No, if you split this, it just means a wall along the north-south axis in Sanskrit language. And you could ask, how did they come up with all these precise markings and the curves? Originally, it was the opposite way. You make these markings slowly every day as the sun moves. So all you need is a wall and a few rods and a thread to calculate these things. Now, you can keep marking the altitude and declination of the sun and also the path of any celestial object. And once you start plotting the movement of celestial objects, you will realize that they follow a strange pattern. Starting today, let's say you take a picture of the sun every day at noon. After 365 days, if you put all the pictures together, the sun's path will look like this, like an infinity symbol. This pattern is called an analemma. Why? Imagine the surprise of early astronomers who first observed this, right? Why is the sun moving like this? And what about the moon? How will the lunar path look? The moon will also make a strange pattern, and it's easier for you to trace it because you can complete the whole path in one lunar month. What about the planets? What about Mars, for example? Mars actually retreats. It will move like this and then starts returning and then move again. This is crazy. This is called the retrograde motion of Mars. And Indians knew about this many, many centuries ago. Even though this particular wall is only 300 years old, they used similar yantras more than 1,000 years ago. And this is how they calculated the motion of all celestial objects. So what do you think? Do you think today we can build a wall and learn so much about astronomy? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.